Yeah, it was a 1v1, and each of us were probably taking about 5 to 10 minutes on a turn. Yeah, it was a little bit ridiculous. I lost, but came really close to getting it. I was just playing against the end from work. He found out later, though, that he could have won much earlier, but he just kind of played wrong. Yeah, that's fine. I mean, I would say we'll probably just play Commander.
A small building stands curiously alone in the center of the cove.
The loathsome orc captain of the ill fate stands before.
The trial will be treacherous. Be aware of every step you take.
What do you mean, like you don't know like where to go or something? Gotcha. Well, so far so good in this place.
You have dismantled the rusty iron defenders. This is sure to be the first of many surprises.
Hopefully I have enough scrolls of prismatic ray to actually get through this, because I'm going to try to get rid of the power relays in this quest here, exile them. Yeah, it's one of the ways that you can do it in here without having another person. Or a hireling. Both of which I kind of forgot about. wonder if they changed how the spell works. It seemed to be working.
An intricate system of ladders leads up the shaft. Agility and physical endurance will be paramount in overcoming this challenge.
I've been playing this this entire life. I don't know, kind of has some sort of challenge to it. Yeah. Wish the wilderness had more challenge just in general, just more mobs.
Your muscles are worn and weary from the ascent up the agility trial, but you must proceed. The fetid stench of sewer fills your nostrils.
Well, it doesn't look like this old trick works anymore, so looks like I kind of have to do this legitimately somehow. Yeah, so just
you survived the warforged ambush. Now the constructs cease to exist. The floor opens up to reveal an elaborate obstacle course. One wrong step could put an end to the trial. A series of levers and traps dot the walls, the floor, and the ceiling. Only your wit can solve this conundrum. Thank you.
Oh, it's really great. It's, you know, more peaceful, I guess. Yeah. I still need to find something for the front entryway. I don't have anything up there right now, but no, we'll eventually find something. It's not super high on my priority list.
Pulling this lever fires a dart high above, leading you to believe it is a trigger mechanism.
The other components in the room return to their initial state. This appears to be a reset mechanism. The challenge was no match for your sharp wit. The portcullis rumbles open.
Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna do this one. This one takes way too much time for it to work.
You hear a metallic clanking from behind, coming closer and closer.
I just need 130,000 more.
A sweltering wave of heat washes over your body. Rackham's Inferno will take precision and cunning to overcome.
Yeah, it says that each of my party members must meet the requirements of this quest, so it would not let me recall. Which is really weird too, because I'm gonna go out to Amroth next and it's not gonna have that issue. I already did Reaper out there, so I'm just gonna do Elite. That'll be easier, Jint, than doing those House C quests.
4 o'clock.
You have weathered Rackham's inferno. A few burns and sweat coat your skin.
Wow, now I end up with the same message out here. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and drop party since this is now a thing. Alright, see you. Yep, I'll see you probably an hour and a half, so.
Penzance. First mate of the ill fate motions for you to come over and speak with him. You survived the ghouls of Rackham's trial. A small building stands curiously alone in the center of the cove. The current is drawn into an opening in the rock just large enough to wiggle through. A thick fog rises up from the water as voices of pirates float along the current. Moonlight shines down from an opening above. The entryway into the pirate's compound rumbles open. A strong breeze gusts from a crack in this wall. Suddenly, the clanking of wood and metal intensifies. A slight breeze slips through a crack in the wall before you. This gate is closed, but appears to be in working order.
You notice a lever on the back of the ornamental statue. The shape of a lever pokes through a tangle of webs. When you pull the lever, you hear the sound of a gate rattling open. A scrag tree. One of the burning logs would make a good club. The scrag falls to your unrelenting assault.
Chilling air gusts out. It smells of raw, bloody meat. You hear the gnawing and crunching of bones inside.
Again, the clattering of Warforged. One springs at you, eager to attack. Farrier calls out to you. Do not touch anything. One wrong move could kill me. Please, speak with me first.
You have freed Farrier Warley from the ancient prison.
The current is drawn into an opening in the rock just large enough to wiggle through.